Hello everyone and welcome back to my tutorial, and today I will show you how we can create this railing for disabled people. As you can see, this is complicated enough, and we will create today for whole this tutorial will be about this handrail. So let's get started. Let's open up some project and let's start to create our new handrail. This is a previous project, you can download it in from the previous video. There you will find link to download this template. So let's select our handrail and let's start to work with that. You should go to the additional type, let's go to the edit type, and if you don't have this window, you should open up just preview. Just using this button preview and choose here 3D view 1, and you will see your the handrail by 3D view. So, and the first thing, we will go to the rail structure non-continuous. Let's go here inside. Let's open up the maximum one and let's start to modify it. Here I want make to 900 millimeters. Here I want make 750 millimeters. Let's do it here the 600 millimeters. And here I will create like 300 millimeters, and I need one more. To create one more, we can duplicate or we can insert. Let's use the insert, and I will use the bottom up and or down to locate where I want to use it. I will use the components down, and I will use here the 150 millimeter, and here let's change. Now we will start from that one. So for that one we will use this circular one. Where is this circular one? 30 millimeters, and for all of them we should get the other type of the profile, but we don't have it right now. As you can see, we have only rectangular one, 50 by 50 millimeters, but I need 20 by 20 millimeters. So for now we will say okay, we will say again okay, and you will get something like that. So now you should go to the open up the families in your project browser, find here the profiles, and after that find here the rectangular one. Let's find the rectangular one, and here you will find profile handrail rectangular. Let's open up and you will see 50 by 50, but we need 20 by 20, as I said. So how we can do that? Just right click on that and you will find here edit. Let's go inside to the edit, and we now inside our profile. We don't need to do anything, we will just go to the properties. Let's go here and you can see the type name 50 by 50. Let's create the new 20 by 20 millimeters. Let's do everything properly, and the naming we will save properly. Let's say okay, and now we will change 20 by 20. So okay, let's say okay. Let's load inside to our project. And let's override it. Now if you will go back to the our profiles, let's open up, and you will find here 20 by 20 millimeters. So it means we can use it for our project. So what we're gonna do next? Just select your handrail, let's go to the edit type, and let's find here again the rail structure. Let's go to edit, and I will make the my window a bit bigger to your better see, and you can see here the 30 millimeters. As I said, we should use this one, profile handrail rectangular 20 by 20, and let's use it for all of them except the last one. So let's use the 20 by 20 and 20 by 20. As you can see here, it's nothing changing, so it happens. Just say okay and again okay, and now you will see here the rectangular one and here the circular one. So this is what we want. So let's continue to make changes. Let's go more deeper. Select again your handrail, go to the edit type, and find here the balustrade placement. Let's go here, and you will find here the balustrade placement. What we're gonna do? We will duplicate that one. Now we have two regular balustrades here. So, and what I'm gonna do here right now? For example, you can see now it's vertical one. So before we will use a horizontal one, now we are using the vertical one. And here I need the square one. Let's use the square one, 25 millimeters, for example. Here we will be used the 25 millimeter. After that, we need to use the host. I will explain later on what is mean host. So the host will be rail 4, and for the second one it will be also rail 4. Let's say like this. After that we need the base offset. Let's make minus 300 millimeter and minus 300 millimeter too on that side. So after that we need the top. With making the top the let's leave it top the rail element, and top rail element here too. And after that we will use distance of the from the previous 300 millimeters here and 150 millimeters on that side. Done. For that one we finish. Now let's I'll show you what it means the host. Let's say OK and let's go back to the edit type. And here you will see the rail 4, rail 3, rail 2. So that means for the rail 4 is that one, the rail 3 that one, rail 2 this one, and rail 1 is here. And new rail what we created, it's that one, circular one. So as you understand, this is a host for our railing what we're creating on this side. So it will be like a host. So okay, so we now understand how it's working. Let's say okay and let's go back to the additional balustrade. So what we're gonna do now? Now we will change here the balustrade. I also wanna change it to the square one. Let's use it, square one 25 millimeters. It's actually not enough. But okay, for now it's we will use the 25 millimeters and the host one we will choose again the rail 4. Let's use the rail 4 and rail 4 here. So the base offset it will be minus 300 millimeter. You can play around to understand how it will work with your the handrail, but believe me, you should do as I'm doing now. So and here the space I will do minus 20 millimeter, and here the definitely different one 20 millimeter plus. So and the offset we will leave like a zero. Let's say okay. Let's say okay. And now you can see we get our balustrade like that one. So this is pretty close what we want, but it's still not finished. We just under construction, let's say. Let's prepare some other settings before we will create something new. Let's go to the additional type, and now we will work with additional type of this handrail. So what we're gonna do now, we will use the landing head. Let's use it. And now we need add the vertical and horizontal segments. After that we need extend rail to mid, so we are using that, and we need weld our staircase. Oh, the handrail, let's say okay. After that I need change here to 1200 millimeter because now it's too small using to 900 only, and let's go and change the type of the top handrail what we are using. Let's duplicate it and we will call it like the 40 millimeters, let's call it diameter 40 mm. Let's call it like that and let's change it now. So what we're gonna do next we should use the fillet. Let's use the fillet, and after that we should use the 50 millimeters by 60 millimeters, and after that we should use the profile by 40 millimeters. Okay, so and simple one, okay. So after that we will go to the length and we'll use 300 millimeters here and 300 millimeters here too. And here we don't need now use our family, let's say none and let's say okay. Let's say okay again, and we did small changes as you can see right now. Let's now do one more changes. We did now changes for the top rail. As you can see, we changed our top rail. Now it's going a bit left, as you can see. And now we will change the other one rail. The rail. Let's go inside again additional type. And here inside you will find the handrail one. Let's use the handrail one, and you can see this is none. We will change it, just open up and let's create the new one of that. So let's duplicate it and we will call H the height. It's 900 millimeters and diameter it will be 40 millimeters only. Let's say okay. So what we will gonna do? So for that one we will use the fillet one, and after that again 50 millimeters by 60 millimeters. 900 millimeters, okay. Profile will be here the 40 millimeters, but here it's 30. Let's change it to the 40 millimeters, and it will be none here. As you can see, transaction is here. The simple, we will use the none. So after that, we will go to the straight away to the supports, because we need to use the support. So it's first time when we will use it. Here the standard one. Let's change the standard one. Let's leave it the standard one. Maybe later on and at the next tutorial we will create our own support. So and the layout it will be fixed one. And here the spacing will be 700 millimeters and it will be on the center. So here nothing much else as you can see. Let's say okay, let's say again okay. And as you can see nothing because I forgot one thing. Let's select them and let's go again to additional type. And as you can see the handrail, we are using the type of the handrail, but position it's none. We should use the position. Without any position, Revit not will create the handrail number one. Let's use the right one, let's apply it, and you will see now changes. Yes, of course, we'll say okay, and you can see this is now lowest one position for our handrail. So it will be going with the connectors, with anchors. So this is really cool. The next time we will create own anchors, but for now it's pretty enough. So we are really close to the finish. Now we will work again with the parameters. So select again your the handrail. Let's go inside to the settings. And now we will work to this other parameter. It's handrail too. So this is pretty last parameter. And let's go inside to that. And now we will duplicate it. So let's go to duplicate it. And we will call it on the properly name. Let's call it like height is equal to the 700 millimeter and diameter is equal 40 millimeters. So now we understand how it will be work. Okay, so and now again we will change to the fillet. Now we will change it 50 by 60 millimeters fillet radius. And here, of course, because our height is 700 millimeters, and here it will be 700 millimeters too. Our diameter is 40 millimeters. Let's change to the 40 millimeters here to the circular 40 millimeters. And we not will use any transitions. Let's use the none. And after that, we will go directly here the nothing. We will go directly here. We will use the supports, standard family, okay, the fixed distance, 700 millimeters, let's say 700 millimeters by center, let's say okay, and as we did before, we should use here the right position, so let's use the right position, let's say okay, and then we create our handrail, so it's totally what we want, and as you can see, it's for disabled people. We have the one handrail for the just as usual, and two handrails for disabled people and the children's, as you can see. So congratulations, and you can use this model in your projects. And before I will finish, I will just fix some mistakes. Sorry, I also did mistake. As you can see, the second handrail is directly on the our rail, but the second one, I mean the first one, it's not. So let's change it a bit and to make it everything perfect. So we should go to the handrail one. Let's open up, and it's not 900 millimeters as you already understand. Let's try 850 millimeters. Let's apply it. And yes, this is 850 millimeters, as you can see right here. Just look at here and you will see on the position. Okay, so and what we're gonna do, we will go inside and we will change the name. Let's go back here the 900 millimeters. Let's duplicate it and let's call it 850 millimeters. Okay, and now we will change 900 to 850. Let's say okay. So now everything all right. Let's say okay. And now you can see it's on position. So guys, I hope you find this tutorial really useful. The next tutorial will be also about the handrail. If you want to support me, don't forget go to Patreon. And if you want to buy some models, you can go to the my store to the Gumroad. And if you want to download this model, you can go below this video and download it. To support my channel, you can go to Gumroad, check that my store. There you can find a bundle of this Dynamo scripts, or you can buy two-story complete house or even the two-story residential classic house. By this way, you're supporting my channel and you're making me happy to creating the new videos for you guys. And that's it from today. Thank you guys for watching. Don't forget to subscribe my social media, leave some comments for this video and give some like, and see you next time.